I think we can actually start doing a little bit of a Q&A right now. So, if anyone wants to ask any questions to Tocho-san?
Any crappy, you know, questions on my love life or, you know?
Everything is open.
My adultery or anything? I have so many tentacles.
Hello, Maya Desan.
Hello.
I was wondering what exactly was the inspiration for you to start drawing tentacle hentai. I've seen there's an old-timey ukiyo-e painting, Dream of a Fisherman's
Hokusai, right? In Edo era, in Japan, right?
Yeah, I was wondering if maybe you had drawn any inspiration from that, or what led you to start doing tentacle stuff?
Actually, subconsciously, I was or not, influenced by Hokusai, such tentacle art, but, I didn't reckon myself that I saw it before. But when I created tentacle scene, in our days, Japanese censorship about manga was so strict. So the sexual scene in bed is big no-no thing. So, even it's the missionary one, it's not, right? So I thought there's some way to have couple connected. If your equipment is way bigger, it would reach. it's necessary, to be a 6 feet or 7 feet or 10 feet, right? And so, no one has that, right? As a human being. So probably creature or, some, weird, the green monster from outer space might be, better to have several tentacles, right? Yeah, so that's what I thought, yes.
As they say, go big or go home.
Thank you. Actually, we have one person with a question up front, so if I could have my screen come up front for a second.
Right. Hey, I was just wondering what your thoughts on your anime adaptations of your work were, specifically La Blue Girl. I noticed that the manga was very tonally different than the anime, which was a lot more humorous and I was wondering what you thought of that, the differences that show
up
in the anime adaptations.
Manga's world is really narrow. It's really, how can I say it, segmented. On the other hand, anime's world is way bigger because they are moving, they have music, so they have so many sequences. And it's quite understandable, right? Because the effect or everything, and the characters, voice or everything, it's like alive. Character look like alive, not 2D, two-dimensional world. They are living. They are living in three-dimensional world, right? So probably the editor, director, try to expand my world into three-dimensional world. So probably the storyline supposed to be changed, right? Or theme or concept supposed to be changed. And I'm really gratified with that. Yes. Thank you.
Hi, yes. Hopefully this is not for a very long time, but do you still want your tombstone to read Tentacle Master?
people call me Tentacle Master, but only one thing and thus in my groin is just a prostate gland. So, I don't know how you call me right now.
Hello?
Hello?
At least I'm not the only woman in this room, thank God. Dude.
Thank you for being victim here.
Thank you, Pastor. My question is, considering that censorship back in the 80s is like, was pretty strict, what do you think of hentai manga now?
Now? I think, you know, I don't read manga. Actually, you know, I always told my kid, don't read manga. It's just the way making money. I'm joking, sorry. But right now, you know that even in Japan, censorship got loosened. Because, you know, that through the internet, you can see, you know, whatever you want, like, you know, the Totally Biba short or anything you can watch, right?
Yeah, so it's like the song, the internet is for porn.
Yeah, law is nothing right now. Seems like nothing, right? So, you know, the publisher don't care about such censorship. You know, a middle-sized publisher. Of course, you know, big publisher care about their reputation, you know, because if, you know, something happen, it put, you know, a stigma on, you know, on the publisher, right? So, but I think, you know, the middle-sized publisher don't care about such censorship. Yes.
Wow, thank you for answering my question. Wow.
Thank you.